the podium. Let's listen in.
How does it feel from your perspective to kind of be that on Boston's side of things? And what kind of responsibility do you think you can take to improve in that area moving forward?
It's okay. Every time they draw it, basically call a foul. So I try to be better. Gotta get better.
Middle here.
Blake Elliott, 105 through the fan. Luca, just take us through, right here in the middle, just take us through your emotions when you foul out of the game and you see your team trying to fight back into it.
I mean, yeah. We had a good chance. We know we were close. Just didn't get it. I wish I was down there.
Any other questions for Luca? Got Tim right here, first row.
Tim McMahon, ESPN. Luca, what did you think of the whistles that went against you in the fourth quarter?
I mean, I don't know. We couldn't play physical, so I don't know. I don't want to say nothing, but, you know, six foul in the NBA Finals, where I'm like this. Come on, man. Better than that.
You guys came out cooking in the first quarter, I think 25 points to like 7 minutes. What happened to make, to bog down the offense? What happened to make scoring more difficult there?
I think we should just keep playing, with the same energy, keep the same people in. We were rolling down there, but then they came back. At some point we were down 21-2 in the fourth quarter, and we came back. So we're going to still believe till the end.
Brad Townsend, Dallas Morning News. We know you've only fouled out three times in the NBA. Have you ever had four fouls called on you in that short of a span?
Sorry?
Do you ever recall having four fouls on you being called in that short of a span?
Not really. I don't think it never happened to me. I remember.
And what did you guys do right to turn around the game and pull off that 20-2 rally?
Just playing with pace. They didn't. We played good defense, and then we played with pace. Just driving, kicking, and that's how we got back to the game.
Tomer here on the left.
Tomer with Charlie with Clutch Points. Luca, you mentioned staying positive. I guess, again, scoring just seems to be a big issue for you guys. What outside of just staying positive can you guys do? Are you seeing the process that you want to offensively, or are there more things you need to see out there?
I think we got to figure out some things. We played three times against them now, so we're getting to know them. I think being down 21 in third game and then came back, was a really positive thing for us.
Dan, you're on the left.
Dan Devine, Yahoo Sports over here, Luca. I think the number is 156 teams been down 3-0 in a series. Not one has come back yet. Having come so close tonight with that best punch you threw, how do you get into the right mindset to be able to get one on the board in game 4?
Yeah, I mean, like I said, it's not over till it's over. So we just got to believe. Like I always say, it's 1st of 4. We're going to stay together. We lose together, we win together. So we got to stay together.
Aether on the left and the back.
Luca, Kevin Sherrington, Dallas Morning News. 4 years ago, Jerry West had a lot of really nice things to say about you and projected how great he thought you were going to be. I wonder what that meant to you when he said that and what were your thoughts about his passing?
I'm sorry. I didn't see what he said. I don't know, but, he was a legend. We're all going to miss him. He's the logo, so he was an amazing player. I wasn't born yet, but I saw some highlights. He was an amazing player.
Hola, Luca. Saber cómo estás y cómo afecta el hecho de que entre este partido y el cuarto sea los dos partidos en los que hay menos tiempo de recuperar. Mañana ya estáis con el Media Day y pasado jugando otra vez.
Así ha sido todos los playoffs de antes, así que hay que prepararse, descansar mañana y a por el cuarto partido. Bien, bien.
Last row, last question.
Mojca, Radio Slovenija. Luka, kako se zdaj izbrati in pripraviti
na naslednjo tekmo in pozabiti to, kar se je zdaj zgodilo, kako nekako držati visoko moralo?
Gremo naprej, mislim. Naslednja tekma je najbolj važna, tako da bomo naprej.
All right, back here in studio with John Gonzalez as we listened to Luka Doncic there, and they asked him about the call in the fourth quarter with 4 minutes to play where he fouled out. He said, I don't know. And then he said, come on, man, be better than that. I mean, he's clearly frustrated with the call. Mm-hmm. You thought maybe on his home floor the refs swallow the whistle there, but it's not even their job. I mean, it goes back to review.
Yeah, when you go back to review and you look at it, by the letter of the law, his feet were not set. He was still technically moving. Now, you also see Jaylen Brown extend his arm as he goes into Luka's body. And if you're going to talk about who initiates more contact, it's Jaylen Brown. But again, letter of the law is if your feet aren't completely set, if you're still moving and you're in motion as the defender, it's going to go against you 9 times out of 10. The problem is that one time that you're talking about, swallowing the whistle, if you're a Mavs fan or you're the Mavs, man, you wish it was tonight, because you're on your home floor knowing that if you lose this game, it is super over. Doesn't matter if you go back to Boston. That's just for window dressing.
Yeah.
So that is a killer.
Kyrie had his best game.
He finally showed up.
He went for 35. I told you to take the over on his prop. You jumped on board. Bill did not, but Bill had the Celtics winning this game.
Yeah.
Shouts to Bill Ryder. Shouts to the Boston Celtics getting it done, because the fact that what happened, they went on a 41-19 run to start the second half. They took a 21-point lead. It would have been one of the all-time biggest collapses in NBA Finals history. I mean, they erased nearly a 21-point lead, the Dallas Mavericks, cut it to 3.
Yeah.
I mean, what they did, they just ran out of gas. I mean, to use all of that effort, right, to rally from 21 down and to not be able to overcome and get over the mountaintop, if you will, it's the gut punch. It's the finishing blow. It's like in Mortal Kombat, finish him.
That's 100% right. And it has to be incredibly frustrating if you're the Dallas Mavericks to say, Kyrie finally showed up. He had an amazing game tonight. No Kristaps Porzingis. Crushed the Celtics in points in the paint, right? You do all these things well tonight. You hold them to 106 points. Still not enough. I mean, at this point, you have to go, what do we have to do to beat these guys?
I know. What do they have to do?
Who knows? We haven't figured it out.
Right.
I don't know that it's possible for the Dallas Mavericks to beat the Boston Celtics the way that these two teams are constituted, because there's just so many different looks that the Celtics can throw at you. There's so many different ways that they can beat you. And the Mavs have to be perfect. And they were close to perfect tonight, but they weren't entirely perfect. Luka fouls out. That was it. That was it.
It was over. But there was still a moment there where you thought maybe Kyrie could have some magic, right? Maybe he could rekindle what happened in 2016 with the Cavaliers. Maybe he could do that. Because he was unable to do that in Boston, unable to do that in Brooklyn, didn't get a chance to even be in this position. And just missed a couple shots. They missed back-to-back threes. We saw P.J. Washington miss a big three in the corner. Kyrie missed a three. So the opportunity was there. They just didn't seize it. They got it close, but look, you know, close only counts in hand, and you know what it is. I'm not saying. I don't need to say it.